Hello and welcome to the latest video from the Dutch Watchdude. Today I have a vintage Citizen Quartz. I think it's a unisex watch. It's from the early 80s when everything was looking a little bit square. And even ladies' watches were kind of bigger than they were in the 60s and the 70s. It's not a huge watch, it's a nice watch. The crown is not signed. It's running on a 377 battery, if I'm right. So it's a watch that is still very easy to service. You can see the crystal has some scratches. As always with Japanese movements, you can see, I don't know if I can zoom even more. And that works. You can see the movement number and the case number. It gives you all information that you actually need, because Citizen has a very nice website, and there are a lot of websites from fans that actually put those websites up. They put a complete database from the watches they made from the early days till now. So you can just use those numbers to figure out when it's made and what is inside the watch. You can see that it is even have a serial number. This watch is not in the best shape, let's say that directly. You can see people have opened it with probably the most strange power tools they were around. Luckily the sides of the watch are not damaged. It is completely surrounded with little scratches, but yeah, if you have a watch this old, and it never was an expensive watch, not even in the days that it was sold, so yeah, people don't treat the watches as good as probably the watch deserved. Deserves, is it, of course. What can I say about this watch? This watch comes with the original strap. It's a double gold-like material. It is steel. I think it's rust-free steel, because it's not oxidated anywhere. I did, of course, clean it with ultrasound between the links, and it looks actually pretty nice. What I always like is that a watch comes with the original clasp. In this case, it's signed by Citizen. It is a safety clasp, because if you open it, I was just gonna say, if you're able to open it, you close the little thingy and you lock it, so it will not fall from your wrist. Actually, with those clasps, it happens more often than you think, because all that keeps it together is this little bar. If it is bent or just wear it out, those clasps comes easily loose and will drop from your wrist. Another thing you have to keep in mind is that you put it right on the strap. I put it completely on the end, but that is more or less done to keep it on the stand. I used one of those watch stands that are actually from plastic, and to put them in a nice way on the stand you have to adjust the strap a little bit, and in this case I had to put it completely on the end. And